Now, the real estate sector has had high hopes from the new BJP-led NDA government. With the union budget for 2014-15 just around the corner, there has been a let-up in the expectations. But will this budget be any different for the real estate sector? Will this government live up to the expectations of the sector and deliver what the sector has asked for? Onitham Ojha tells you what to expect from this budget.
Governments have changed, but the real estate sector's budget wish list continue to be the same down the years. Infrastructure status for the sector has been one such long-standing demand. Infrastructure status would help the sector access money for the business at better interest rates and allow tax exemptions up to 10 years.
This industry is accelerated, that's a realty sector. Automatically 250 industries will get a boost along with this. So first and foremost, we have demanded infrastructure status and the industry status to this realty sector.
Then there is the much-awaited and much-talked-about Real Estate Investment Trust, which has been pending since 2008. These would allow companies sitting on built assets to unlock value, create liquidity and make the market more transparent.
Just going to accelerate the funding which will go in the real estate market. It'll bring in a new instrument. Retail investors will get an opportunity to invest. And it will, the most important part of the REIT, except besides all the funding, is that it is a major exit route for people who are investing money.
Industry players are also very hopeful of tax incentives, particularly for the affordable housing segment, a priority area of the present government, along with a review of external commercial borrowing norms to allow better access to foreign direct investments. They are also keeping their fingers crossed for service tax breaks.
The other important thing government could examine is the controversial imposition of service tax on purchase of apartments, etc. It is very sad that a single transaction is treated as a service by the central government and treated as a works contract by the state government and also as a sale by another arm of the state government.
The ministry has also asked for increasing the tax exemption limit on home loans from the current levels of 1.5 lakh rupees per annum to 2.5 lakh rupees per annum, and at least 3% of funds under priority lending segment be earmarked by banks for the housing sector. But the key hope remains that the budget will convert the optimism on economic revival into reality. That holds the key to bringing life back into India's listless real estate sector.
Giving concessions in either in taxes or taking away a tax or adding a tax really will not make any major impact on the economy or impact on our lives. In fact, a budget is probably has to set a course, a certain direction where the country needs to go.
For the first time, the sector found mention in the president's speech. Now, given the Prime Minister's thrust on affordable housing and creating new cities, there seemed to be a glimmer of hope for the sector this time round. In New Delhi, Onitha Moja, NDTV.